Hello and welcome. My name is Chris Shelton, coming to you from a beautiful, warm summer's day in Los Angeles, California. And speaking of summer in Los Angeles, I thought it'd be a great idea to talk about heart health, because did you realize that most heart attacks actually happen during the summer months? And actually, during certain seasons of the year, certain organs are more prone to disease. So during the summer months, the heart is actually more prone to disease. So according to traditional Chinese medicine, the heart is paired with the small intestine and the pericardium. Now the pericardium, for those of you that don't know what the pericardium is a sac that protects the heart. In fact, and I love this word, I'm going to go ahead and use it, the six pernicious influences, summer heat actually will attack the pericardium and then attack the heart. So the pericardium is like a sheath or a sac that protects the heart itself. Now the pericardium is also paired with what is referred to as the triple burner, triple warmer, sanjiao, or the three that burn. And what is a triple burner? It's not actually a physiological organ. It's more of the function of the three major areas of the visceral cavity. So the upper burner is considered like the mist. This is where your lungs and heart are. This is where the qi or the blood is actually formed. The middle burner is the maceration chamber. This is actually where the food and the drink is assimilated to be made into blood and energy for the body. And then the lower burner is considered the drainage ditch, where then the urine and the fecal matter then leave the body. But also like the bladder, for example, as well as the large and small intestine also play a role in recycling food that's undigested, or drink that's undigested, and further breaking apart the pure from the impure. So it's kind of like a catalytic converter in a car. A catalytic converter in a car takes the unburned gases and recirculates it around, so it's used up and it's really good for smog. So inside of our body, our catalytic converter then would be your small intestine, large intestine, as well as the bladder. So when you digest the food and it goes into the intestinal tract or into the bladder, there still is pure qualities. And from there, those pure qualities are re-assimilated around the body to help to moisten the skin, to help with the functioning of the lungs, the moisture between the skin and the lungs, or the skin and the muscles themselves. And so the body is a very unique organism. In fact, it tries to use up as much of the food and drink that we put into our body. So going back to the heart is related to the fire element. The direction of south is benefits the heart. So if you're somebody that is deficient in heart chi, for example, let's say you're somebody that actually has a heart condition, you could actually put the head of the bed in the south in order to go ahead and help to strengthen the energy of the heart. Other simple feng shui techniques that you could go ahead and do is you could find little diamonds or little triangles, pyramid shape. You know, the pyramid shape actually will help to benefit the heart. And it's even better if you could actually find ones that are red or pink in nature, because the color red or the color pink is also beneficial for the heart. That's the reason why I'm standing next to these beautiful orchids right here. So when we're looking at the heart and the emotion of the heart, the negative emotions that attack the heart are the emotions of abandonment, loneliness, lack of joy in one's life. But overexcitation, mania also affect the heart. And in fact, in the summer heat, the heat gets much higher. The heart is already prone to disease. People may tend to notice that they're more manic or more uneasy. They may notice a little bit of inability to speak properly, as I just tripped over my own words right there. So slurring of the words, or your tongue, you get tongue-tied or whatnot, that also could be an expression of the heart chi being out of balance. The heart also influences sweat as well too. And so during the summer months, we may notice things like more heart palpitations, angina. You may notice that if you have high or low blood pressure, that is aggravated more. And so what are the remedies to help to benefit us during the summer heat when this organ is most prone to disease? And one of the simple practices that you can go ahead and do is Qigong. And I love doing Qigong. I love doing Tai Chi as well too, but Qigong is great because you can take it with you anywhere. You don't need a yoga mat, you don't need special clothing or anything. You can do it from a seated position, you can do it from a standing position. And the whole idea of it is to empower you, to give you tools in order to deal, and not only with stress, but also to help to keep the proper functionality of these internal organs. In fact, if you, I don't know if you know this or not, but if you go to the Center of Disease Control's website, most heart attacks actually happen in the summer months. So today what I'm doing is I'm talking about summer heat and how it affects the heart itself. And when the heart is out of balance too, the heart, they actually say in Chinese medicine, that the heart houses the mind, which houses the shen, which is your spirit. And you could actually tell if a person has a disturbed shen because their eyes will sound like helicopters. In fact, you can actually tell if somebody has a disturbed shen because their eyes will lack any type of luster. So if you look at somebody's eyes and they look like, and it looks like nobody's home, or the eyes are dull or lusterless, that means that there's a disturbed shen. And once again also, disturbance of the speech is also a sign that the heart is out of balance. You know what else could be a sign that the heart is out of balance too? Is the when somebody gets chronic hiccups. Now true, sometimes if you drink something like a soda or something like that, or if you eat something wrong, you could create hiccups doing that. But if you have a chronic case of hiccups, and I know people that have had to been hospitalized because of hiccups, who talks about hiccups? Well, this video here, we're talking about hiccups because this actually can become a medical condition. So severe that a person has to be hospitalized and actually put under in order for the body to calm down. But that is always related back to the heart as well too, and a mental and emotional stress. So, two different kinds of heart attacks that we have. We have one type of heart attack where obviously there's too much heat in the body. So eating things that are spicy, for example, or greasy, fatty, fried food, drinking too much alcohol, smoking cigarettes, smoking too much marijuana, could actually cause an increase in this fire energy inside the body, which can actually contribute to a heart attack. But also, if the kidneys aren't doing their job properly and there's too much water, meaning there's not enough kidney yang, or there's not enough of this kidney's ability to move fluids around, so to warm the heart. And we can normally tell those types of heart conditions because the person will have swelling of the hands, swelling of the face, swelling of the feet. Okay, so there's a couple of different types of heart attacks that could come around, and what can we do to prevent this? So number one, obviously, is your diet. Look at your diet. Avoid greasy, fatty, fried foods. Avoid sugar. Avoid processed foods. Avoid foods that are hot in nature, spicy nature in excess, especially if you're somebody that has propensity for heart disease. Try to avoid those types of foods. Too much salt. Again, too much salt. The salty flavor actually benefits the kidneys on when it's in small amounts, like sea salt, for example, will actually benefit the kidneys. But when in excess, it actually will dry out the kidneys and contribute to heart disease and can lead up to a potential heart attack. So diet, we need to look at our diet, avoiding those foods that I just recommended. The other thing too is avoiding too much red meat also, or there's all this controversy going back and forth about how much meat you need in your diet. It all depends on how physically active you are. And I talked about this in one of my videos about 3 months ago about the meat we eat and making sure that the meat that you have, if you are eating meat, is grass-fed, that those animals are taken care of and that they are processed in a humane way. So avoiding the too much excess consumption of red meat, for example, and introducing foods of the summer. So this is the time of year where you'd want to go ahead and have more salads. For me, I love arugula salad, arugula and spinach salads, and you could go ahead and put a slice of peaches in there, some nectarines in there, because right now nectarines and peaches are in season. Oh, watermelon's in season, so, you know, and cherries are in season. So introducing watermelon and cherries into your diet during this time of year, not in excess, though. Obviously, you're not going to be eating watermelon throughout the day or cherries throughout the day, but introducing watermelon and cherries into the diet, because energetically speaking, those fruits are energetically cooling. Cucumber also. Mint is also cooling for the body. So what can we do as a nourishing, fulfilling drink to help to cool our heart and benefit our body? Well, we could take some room temperature water, and we soak some mint, we soak some pieces of watermelon in there, some pieces of cucumber, and let it sit for a little bit, and voila, you have a great drink that's really good for you, helps to cool the heart down energetically and cool the body down. And that's the other thing too, is a lot of times people want to consume things with ice. And they think, well, the ice is going to actually cool me down, but it does just the opposite. Because when you ingest ice into your body, or things that are ice cold, then what happens is that the stomach has to heat it up, in order to process it. So most of our bodies operate at about 98.5 degrees, and what happens when you put something cold from the refrigerator or from the freezer, then the body has to heat it up to 98.5 degrees to be able to assimilate it. And most things from the freezer or from the refrigerator, for example, on average are about 54 or 55 degrees. So that heating process that the body has to go through actually creates inflammation. That inflammation can actually aggravate the heart artery walls and actually creates more heat for the body. So if you're trying to cool down, drink room temperature water, drink mint water with some watermelon in it, drink mint tea, believe it or not, would be really good for you to do as well too, to try to get yourself to cool off. Okay, so what can we do? What other things can we do? Well, simple Qigong practices that you can do if you're too hot is pulling down the heavens. So a very simple practice you can do once again from a seated or a standing position, and you just inhale. And just imagine that this white light is coming in through the body, cleansing the body. Inhale and exhale. Inhale. So you can do as many of these as you want. I normally have, when I'm teaching classes or if I'm giving a talk to the public, I normally have people pull down the heavens three times for heaven, earth, and mankind. Okay, so three times is good enough. And exhale. Okay, then the first Qigong movement is a heart move. Now there's two ways to do it. One way is like you're holding a ball, and the hand that's on the bottom of the ball, that hand is going to press to the top as I turn. And then that hand that's on the bottom goes to the bottom of the ball. Inhale in the center, exhale and press. Inhale. So let's say you are feeling agitated. Your mind is feeling agitated. You feel a little bit anxious. You feel like there's something, can't seem to settle your mind down. This is a very simple practice you can go ahead and do to go ahead and help alleviate this excess mania or agitation due to the summer heat actually aggravating the heart. Or if you notice that you're more emotional, let's say you just had a heartbreak, recent heartbreak, relative, parent has passed away, had a breakup of some type, you could go ahead and do this. And the way you make this into more of a mindfulness practice is you would go ahead and focus on a situation or an event, past or present, that has created this mania in your life or this heartbreak in your life. Focus on it, who's involved, what's involved. And as you come to the middle, you're going to inhale, imagine the pink cloud filling up into the heart. As you exhale in turn, you're going to imagine that the negative circumstance leaves like a dark cloud, going several feet away from the body and deep into the ground. Okay, so this is one way to do the heart move. Now this is too confusing, because the whole idea of Qigong is simplicity is profound. We're going to inhale like a cradling a baby, inhale and then press. Now the tip of my tongue is actually going to curl to the roof of the mouth behind the teeth, as if saying the letter N. Exhale, let it go, the agitation, the summer heat. Imagine a cool pink light filling up into the chest as we inhale. As we exhale, allowing that circumstance to leave like a dark cloud, going several feet away from the body and deep into the ground. And when this happens, we let go of this trauma, then the positive virtue of love comes in. So we allow for the positive virtue of love to take place in the mania, the overexcitation, the abandonment, the lack of joy in one's life. So you can do as many of these as you want, whatever feels comfortable for you. Inhale, middle, exhale. Come down to the center, then exhale as we press. And then we finish off by pulling down the heavens three times. Inhale. And exhale. Inhaling. And exhale. Just allow for the white light to come in to cool the body. Inhale. And exhale. Okay, so like I said earlier in this little video shoot, The other contributing factor to heart disease, too, is the kidneys being out of balance. And our kidneys are considered the water element, and they help to keep the fire in check. So the kidneys are considered the water element, the heart's considered the fire element, and it's a proper mixture of fire, water, which produces the steam or the chi that circulates around the body as it produces the blood that sustains our life. So generally speaking, the kidneys are always a deficient organ, but they're normally deficient in yin or yang. And like I was talking about, when it comes to certain types of heart disease, you tell if it's deficient in yang, meaning there's not enough of the heat to warm the heart, by water retention, because what it means is that the body is having an inability to absorb fluids or to move fluids and circulate the fluids around the body. So you can imagine the color blue, like my groovy little blue wave Hawaiian shirt here. You can imagine that color blue or any color blue that you want. And then what you do is you'd actually go ahead and place the hand on the kidney and put the opposite hand here. So right now I have my left hand on my right kidney. I'm going to exhale, baby down the waist. Inhale, easy at the back of the hand, and exhale. So the right kidney is related to kidney A, which is the heat or motor force, which helps to keep the heart move blood around the body. Now you can bend as far as you want, depending on how much of a stretch, but if you have low back problems, my suggestion is to do just a gentle bend. Your tongue position could actually roll back all the way to the soft palate of the mouth. Inhale on the top, exhale. Imagine that blue color filling up into the right kidney, kidney A. And then from there, you know that you're yang deficient, meaning that you have cold extremities, you do have water retention. Maybe you can spend a little bit more time with the right kidney, but ultimately, switch. Now go with the left kidney. My right hand is now on the left kidney. Inhale and exhale. And shifting the weight, imagine a blue cloud filling up into the kidneys. Tongue position still rolled back to the soft palate. Doing several of those, coming back, and then we're going to finish by pulling down the heavens again three times. Inhale, inhaling, and exhale, inhale, and exhale. Okay, so once again, I don't know how clear I was when I had my back towards the camera there, but we want to make sure that we work with both yin and yang aspects, so meaning the left and right kidneys need to be worked with, even if you know or if your acupuncturist has told you, you know, you're kidney yin deficient or you're kidney yang deficient, because ultimately yin and yang is inseparable and one feeds into the next. So like I was saying, if you know that you have a kidney yang deficiency and you do have a propensity for heart trouble, and some of your symptoms are like pale complexion, cold extremities, spontaneous sweating, those types of things, and maybe your yang is deficient, you might want to do a few more movements of the kidney exercise on the right, for the right kidney, because the right kidney relates to kidney yang. But you still have to come back and focus on the kidney and the left kidney as well, to make sure that you keep some type of balance between yin and yang of the body. Oh, and the other thing too that could cause, besides poor diet, not getting enough sleep, burning the candles at both ends, something else that could come up for you that could create kidney deficiency or kidney weaknesses is actually the negative emotions of fear and shock. So if you've had a frightful situation, if you've suffered some type of trauma or shock, maybe a severe illness, car accident, or seen or witnessed something that was shocking, some type of abuse or whatever, believe it or not, this could actually weaken the kidneys, which will affect the heart and other organs of the body, including your brain. And so we want to keep a balance of all these organs. But right now here, during the summer months, just to wrap up here, the heart is more prone to disease. And the heart is connected directly to the small intestine, the pericardium, which is the sac that protects the heart, as well as what is referred to as the triple girder. The color pink or the color red is associated with the heart. The direction of south is associated with the heart. And foods that are bitter in nature, so bitter greens should be consumed if you, not in excess though, but bitter greens and those types of things should be consumed in order to benefit the heart. I talked about also introducing like watermelon during this time of year, peaches, cherries, nectarines, those types of cucumbers, those types of fruits, vegetables that are cooling in nature, so salad I think is really great for you as well too, to be able to help to offset the summer heat. And just to wrap up here from a beautiful day here in Los Angeles, California, congratulations to the women's soccer team for winning the World Cup. Tonight is also the ESPYs in downtown Los Angeles, so we'll be there to check that out. And keep cool this summer. Protect your heart. Protect your mind. Stay well. Eat healthy. Practice your Qigong. And I will chi you later.